بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين إنه خير ناصر ومعين الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين شفيع المذنبين رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا وشفي ذنوبنا وحبيب قلوبنا وطبيب نفوسنا الذي سمي في السماء بأحمد وفي الأرضين بأبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وبآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين صلوات الله عليهم أجمعين ولعنة الله على أعدائهم ومنكر فضائلهم وغاصب حقوقهم من الأولين والآخرين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين أما بعد Respected scholars, distinguished guests, the chairman of FMO, Abdul Karim Bhai Ghiwala, my brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I begin with extending felicitations and congratulations on this auspicious occasion of the birth anniversaries of Sadiqain, of the Holy Prophet of Islam, who was also known as As-Sadiq in the pre-Islamic era. And the enemies, the Kuffare Makkah, the polytheists, gave him this title of As-Sadiq, which means the truthful, the founder of our religion, the one who said, whose slogan was, Kulu la ilaha illallah tuflihu. Say la ilaha illallah and you will succeed. The one who showed us the path of salvation, who gave us najah, Rasulullah. And his sixth successor, the founder of our jurisprudence, Ra'is-e Mazhab, the founder of our school of thought. Again, he's got this title of As-Sadiq. When we talk about Rasulullah, indeed, Quran-e-Majid has said that Rasulullah, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهُ كَثِيرًا. This is Surah Ahzab, chapter 33, verse number 21. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that in Rasulullah, there is an excellent pattern. He is the best role model for you. He is the best exemplar for you. You want a role model? Then Rasulullah is a best example for you. He's the best exemplar for you. But then Quran does not stop there. Quran says, لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهُ كَثِيرًا. Now it is a question that we need to pose to ourselves and think about it. That what does Quran say? Quran says that Rasulullah is a role model for you, for those people, liman kana yarjullah, for those people who have hopes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that, but to have hopes even in the day of judgment, and the one who often, regularly remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dhakarallahu kathira. Do we have these qualities? Do we often remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do we hope on the day of judgment? Do we hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then Allah says that if this is so, then take Rasul as your model. Take Rasul as your role model. In another place in Quran-e-Majid, in Surah Tawbah, at the end of Surah Tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا أَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. This is Surah Tawbah, chapter 9, verse number 128. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ. He says, amongst you, amongst yourselves, we have sent Rasul indeed. And which Rasul? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is defining the qualities of Rasul. He says that, عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَوْفٌ رَحِيمٌ. He's grievous when you fall into distress. This is that Rasul. Azizun alayhi ma anittum. Harisun alaykum. Certainly, he is that Rasul. Harisun alaykum. What does it mean? He is excessively respectful to you. He's excessively caring for you. He's caring for you. Harisun alaykum. Then Quran says, bil mu'minina ra'ufur rahim. To the believers, he's compassionate, very merciful. And immediately Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا فَقُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا هُوَ عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ وَهُوَ رَبُّ الْأَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ. This is the last verse of Surah Tawbah. And I want to give you as a gift tonight. What is this gift? Rasulullah was asked that somebody comes to Rasulullah and says, Ya Rasulullah, I'm in problem. My relative is thrown behind the bars. Give me something, the way you have got people currently saying, give us ta'weez, give us a dua, so that we are free and we are relieved, and we are released from a problem and calamity. Rasulullah says, recite this verse, the last verse of Surah Tawbah. This is again a gift for us. All those who are in problems, if we recite this verse often, the last verse of Surah Tawbah, فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا Rasulullah is being told by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that if the whole universe turn away from you, O Muhammad, فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا say, فَقُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا هُوَ عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ وَهُوَ رَبُّ الْأَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ. Allah is sufficient for me. Allah is sufficient for me. Which Allah? The Lord of the mighty power. And if you... Rasulullah came in that day and age, in that era, that when Rasulullah, on day one, when he comes down from the cave of Hira, when he got this message officially, and when he comes down, he didn't have any defender. He didn't have any supporter. It was Amirul Mumineen and Khadijatul Kubra. This was that Rasul. When he would invite people to come towards the straight path, people would abuse him. The Arabs of Mecca, the polytheists, the mushrikeen of Mecca, kuffare Mecca, would throw stones on him. They would put cotton birds in their ears. They would put cotton in their ears so that they should not listen anything what Rasulullah says, what Rasulullah preaches. But at the end of his life, a time came that it is the same Rasul that people were ready to sacrifice their lives for Islam. You would see a woman carrying the corpse of her child, of her own son. She is, the corpse of the son is on the horse, and she's pushing the horse, and she's being asked, she says that I have lost a son. My son is killed in a particular battle, but I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Rasulullah is saved. This is the time that Rasulullah, how did he change the whole society? He changed the whole community. It was not that easy. But he changed that now Rasulullah, when he's going to Hajj to perform the pilgrimage, when he's performing wudu, the companions did not allow a single drop of water which Rasulullah performed wudu should drop on the floor. They kept their hands. They said that this is tabarruk. They took that water and they started applying on their face. If Rasulullah, after the rituals of Hajj in Halaq, when he was ready to shave his head, they didn't allow a single hair to fall on the ground. They took that hair and they said that this is tabarrukan. This is tabarruk of Rasulullah. In short, we just want to explain you, that is why I didn't sit on the minbar today. Because if I sit on minbar, instead of 20 minutes, it will become 30 minutes. And I don't want to cross the time. Whatever time I've got, I want to stay in that limit, in that bound. So, the only message which I want to convey tonight is that we need to think about this holy man, about this great man. He's such a great personality that Ayatullah Jafar Subhani writes in his book, The Message. He says that when Rasulullah came, he removed the chains from their hands and their feet. From the chains of the people of Mecca. Which chains does Ayatullah Jafar Subhani speak about? Which chains? These iron chains? No, not these physical chains. Those chains, Ayatullah Jafar Subhani says, that they were tied in their minds. Which were those superstitions, those beliefs, those groundless beliefs they had, that Rasulullah freed them and released them. Those chains which were in their minds, those were restraining them from advancement and from development. So Rasulullah removed those chains in reality. Because those physical chains, those iron chains, at the end, if a person is a captive, A time will come that he will be freed. But with superstitious and groundless beliefs, if it stays in one's minds, a person cannot be relieved until his death. Rasulullah gave them salvation. He removed them from those superstitious and groundless beliefs. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 103, Allah says, وَذْكُرُوا اللَّهِ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ إِخْوَانًا وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَا حُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ. Allah says that, remember the time, O the polytheists of Makkah, وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً, you are enemies of each other. فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ إِخْوَانًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought your hearts together and you became brothers. وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَا حُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ, you were at the brink of the fire of hell. But it is Muhammad who came and who took you out from those groundless beliefs, from those superstitions. And that is why Amirul Mumineen says in Nahj al-Balagha, what does Ali alayhi salam say in Nahj al-Balagha? Ali alayhi salam says in Nahj al-Balagha that, O Arabs, O people of Makkah, you are having muddy water, you are having coarse food, you are having lizard. You are fighting with each other. You are holding grudges with each other. You would not speak to each other for many years. You would bury your daughters alive. It was Muhammad who took you out from darkness and brought you to light. It is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we say about the Holy Prophet of Islam, it will be unfair and it will be injustice on the second personality whose birth anniversary we are celebrating tonight. And that is Sadiq Ali Muhammad. Our sixth holy imam, he is also a Sadiq. He is a Sadiq. Sheikh Saduq asked his son that, who is your role model? Since we are discussing about best exemplar, Rasulullah is our role model according to Quran. Sheikh Saduq asks his son that, who is your role model? The son said that, oh father, you are my role model. I want to become like you. You know, what did Sheikh Saduq reply? Sheikh Saduq said that, I wanted to become Imam Sadiq, I became As-Saduq. So if you want to become me, what will you become? Aim high. Sheikh Saduq wanted to become Imam Sadiq. Sheikh Saduq's role model was Imam Sadiq. Ha, Muhtaram Sameen, hamare chhate sarkar ke baare mein milta hai. Ke ek martaba, ek shaks aata hai, hamare chhate sarkar ke paas. اور چھٹے امام سے سوال کرتا ہے اور کہتا ہے کہ ابن رسول اللہ میں چاہتا ہوں کہ میں آپ کی زیارت کرتا رہوں میں بہت دور دراز سے آتا ہوں بدو عرب تھا بہت دور رہتا تھا تو کہنے لگا کہ میں چاہتا ہوں کہ آپ کی زیارت سے میں مشرف ہوں اور رہتا ہوں بہت دور مدینہ تک آؤں مجھے آپ کچھ ایسا عمل دکھائیے اس عمل کے ذریعے خواب میں نیند کے حالت میں میں آپ کی زیارت کر سکوں تو چھٹے سرکار نے فرمایا کہ ایک کام کرو تم نمکین پانی پیا کرو نمک والا پانی پیا کرو اور سو جاؤ تو وہ نمک والا پانی پینے لگا اسی شب انہوں نے نمکین پانی پیا بہت زیادہ تاکہ امام کی زیارت ہو جائے ایکسپیریمنٹ کرنے لگا امام خواب میں آتے ہیں یا نہیں آتے ہیں پوری رات گزری صبح جب نمودار ہوئی تو انہوں نے چھٹے امام کے پاس پہنچ گیا اور چھٹے امام سے شکایت کرنے لگا ابن رسول اللہ میں نے تو بہت نمکین پانی پیا لیکن خواب میں میں نے پانی ہی پانی دیکھا دہ قسم کے پانی دیکھے دہا قسم روایت میں ہے دس قسم کے پانی میں نے دیکھے یعنی سمندر کا پانی دیکھا پتہ نہیں ندی دیکھا میں نے نہر دیکھی سب کچھ میں نے بس پانی ہی پانی دیکھا تو امام نے فرمایا تمہیں پتا ہے میں نے جب تم سے کہا کہ نمکین پانی پیا کرو نمک والا پانی پیو اس کا مطلب یہ تو فقط ایک مثال تھا چھٹے امام فرماتے جب تم نے پانی پیا نمک والا تو تم نے محسوس کیا تمہارا بدن کا احساس ضروری کیا تھا احساس ضرورت پانی تھا تمہاری بدن کا احساس ضرورت پانی تھا کیوں؟ کیونکہ تم نے نمکین پانی پیا لہٰذا تمہارا احساس ضرورت کیا تھا؟ پانی تھا تمہارے بدن نے احساس کیا کہ مجھے پانی کی ضرورت ہے بس ویسے ہی تم ایسے محسوس کرو اپنے آپ کو کہ ہم تمہارے احساس ضرورت ہو
तुम्हारे लिए हम एहसास जरूरत हो, तुम खुद कुछ ऐसे करो, कुछ ऐसा काम करो कि हम तुम्हारे एहसास जरूरत बने। क्यों? जब हम पानी पीते हैं नमकीन तो हमें प्यास लगती है, बदन कहता रहता है, सीना कहता रहता है कि हमें पानी चाहिए। अगर मछली भी खाते हैं तो अंदर जो है दिल कहता रहता है कि पानी पानी, प्यास प्यास। एहसास जरूरत बदन क्या क्या है? पानी है। बस छठे इमाम फरमाते हैं, तुमने समझा नहीं, मैं तुम्हें समझाना चाहता था कि जैसे एक इंसान नमक वाला पानी पीता है तो उनका एहसास जरूरत जो है पानी होता है, वैसे तुम भी हमारे लिए एहसास जरूरत बनो, हम तुम्हारे लिए एहसास जरूरत बने, तुम्हें खुद महसूस हो कि मेरी जरूरत इमाम वक्त है, मेरी जरूरत अहले बैत है, मेरी जरूरत रसूल अल्लाह है, मेरा रोल मॉडल रसूल अल्लाह है। हम खुद अपने बच्चों से भी कहें कि बेस्ट एग्जाम्पलर हमारे लिए रसूल अल्लाह है, बेस्ट एग्जाम्पलर हमारे लिए इमाम सादिक है। आए हम सब मिलके खुदावंद करीम के पास दुआ करें कि पालने वाले बेहक के रसूल अल्लाह, बेहक के इमाम सादिक, तमाम मुहिबान अली, तमाम मुस्लिमीन दुनिया में जहाँ जहाँ पे हो, उनकी जान माल औलाद इज्जत आबरू को महफूज रख। खुदाया जो बे औलाद है उनको तो औलाद सालेह अता कर, जो मकरूज है उनका कर्ज गैब से अदा करना। खुदाया तुझे वास्ता देते हैं मोहम्मद और आले मोहम्मद का, तमाम शियाने अली जो परेशान हाल है खुदाया उनको तू परेशानी से रिहा कर। खुदाया तुझे वास्ता देते हैं साले आयंदा, ये जश्न जो यहाँ पे हम मनाते हैं साले आयंदा, इंशाल्लाह मदीने मुनव्वरा में हमें रसूल अल्लाह और इमाम सादिक की ज़ियारत से मुशर्रफ फरमा, और आखिरत में उनकी शफाअत से महरूम न कर। आखिर में हम सब मरीजों को याद करें, पांच मरतबा हम सब मिलके जो मोमिनीन वर मोमिनात मरीज है उनकी शिफायाबी के लिए हम सब मिलके पांच मरतबा अम्मा यूजीब पढ़ेंगे। अल्लाहुम्मा सल्ले अला मुहम्मद व आले मुहम्मद, बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम। अम्मा यूजीबुल मुज़्तर इज़ा दअ ويكشف السوء أما يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه 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 أفضل السلام بر محمد وآل محمد.